rainy day today. It is pouring down right now, but my wife tagged me on a post on Facebook. We want to go try a restaurant that's in Aguadilla. She said it's not raining in Aguadilla, so let's see how crazy the weather is. Forgot I have to close the door, so I gotta turn off the car real quick and get wet. These things happen because my garage door opener got wet. And see, I closed the door and I'm about to leave. And I left my car door open. What am I thinking? I'm not really thinking straight today. TV's on, everything's on. I think I'm starting off on the wrong foot today. But these things happen when you're trying not to get wet and then you end up getting wet like double because now my door is soaked. But my garage door is open. I mean closed. Now we can leave. Wow, look at that. Yay. Not a good way to start the day leaving the house, but let's get popping. Let's get out of here. Let's go find some sun. Honestly, sometimes I miss having a truck because I wouldn't have a problem with all this water. But you gotta settle for the little micro machine, so hopefully today will be a fun day. Alright, so we made it to the office and it's not raining, so my wife was right. Roman has an opinion too, but we're gonna head out to the restaurant now because my wife just got out of work.
Fried dumplings, really crunchy. They have pork inside, but the pork is well seasoned. It almost tastes like red meat. It tastes so good. What sauce?
It's like a sweet chili.
You is amazing. Check out the mojito. That's the mojito, and that's a guanabana mojito, and it has sun-dried lemons. It's not a watered-down mojito. Definitely has a kick to it. But the alcohol is not overpowering. My wife got a passion fruit one. It's good. I know, it's really strong. I think this is called sour soap. I don't know how to pronounce it. I'll look it up. Alright, so one thing that restaurants here have, like, they don't do is customer service. They don't do that really well. So if you come from the States and you expect, like, stellar customer service, you're probably not gonna get it. But as soon as we got in here, we were served with filtered water. And he came out and gave us the menus and explained everything, asked us how had we found out about them. Specifically, like, we had told them we saw it on Facebook, so that helps the restaurant too see if their ads are working, which they did, because their food looks amazing on pictures. And we just had this amazing the fried dumplings, and they're delicious. The sauce is amazing, so I'm excited for the main course. But the mojitos are really, really good, and they're strong. So it's not like a watered-down mojito where they try to rip you off. It tastes really good. It's sour soft. That's what I got. My wife got passion fruit. The ambience is nice. Music is nice. It's not too loud. So far, restaurants are hit. I really like it, and I'll be coming back. Good, Roman? Hey. Alright, so here's the main course. It's half a pineapple. The chef just told me because the pineapple was little, he just added, you would get the same amount of rice on a bigger pineapple, but he split it, the pineapple, into two. So look at that. Look at the detail on that. So this plate has shrimp and chicken. And it's own pad thai, ¿verdad, mami? Look, Roman's already trying to dig in. That's my wife's pad thai. It has...
it's a stir fry.
Oh, stir fry? Chicken stir fry with peanuts. Alright, so we're back from the restaurant, and Roman's here with me. He's playing with dominoes, just in case you hear them. It might be a little annoying, but the biggest thing that I got from the restaurant is that the food is extremely good. It's well cooked, it's not overcooked, and the flavors are there. Like, the pineapple tastes like a really good pineapple, like a ripe pineapple that was just ready. The peppers, the onions, everything was nicely caramelized. Nothing was burned. The rice was well cooked. The service was phenomenal. So in Puerto Rico, the thing that you most have to desire is the service. You don't get that service that you get in the States. Like, having that server coming around every 5 to 6, maybe 10 minutes, coming up and checking up on you, making sure your drinks are filled up. You don't kind of get that service in Puerto Rico. Some restaurants do, because a lot of them are, at least in this area, are owned by Americans or somebody that has been raised and taught in the, you can say, like, the American culture, and they tend to cater to Americans too in this area. So, but if you go metropolitan area, like you go to Sizzler or you go to any other place, like,
You don't see it. You go to a local pizzeria, you don't see that kind of attention, like trying to make the customer feel good about the food that he's eating. And it's just, sometimes it's just not a pleasant experience. The food could be amazing, but the customer service sometimes is just lacking. So this restaurant had a really good customer service. It was empty. We were the only ones there. I don't know if it was because of the time and the time of the day. So I don't know. I feel like at night, I do know that at night it gets full because it also has a bar area. But I feel like if I were to give it out of 10 stars, I would give it 9 stars. Mainly because the tables were a little sticky. Not that they weren't unclean, but they were a little sticky. So sometimes that happens depending on the treatment of the table. But besides that, everything was super clean. Everything was perfect. The food was perfect. The customer service was perfect. So in terms of price, it depends on what you get. Everything's moderately priced for the area. So a regular plate might cost you maybe $10, $15. The pineapple plate, I believe, cost $29.99. And I believe that it was well worth it. The dumplings were like $8.99, I believe. I don't remember right now, but it was somewhere around that area. So for an appetizer, they were extremely good, well cooked. So thank you guys for coming with us to lunch. I have to get back to my son because he is making a mess here with the dominoes. And he's playing with one of my tripods, but it's the only way I could keep him busy so I can make these videos. So if you haven't liked, please like this video. Leave a comment. Tell me if you've been to Puerto Rican restaurants, what's the thing that you like and what you don't like about them. Also, if you haven't subscribed, please consider subscribing to the channel. Helps me grow and show that at least you guys are enjoying these videos and you hope to see more. And I'll see you guys on the next video. Bye.